When I was little, I loved languages. I loved their abstract structure. I loved being able to translate between languages. I was also interested in more practical things. I loved chemistry. I competed in the chemistry Olympiad. I did pretty well in the theory, but I did destroy half the laboratory when I was doing experiments. It was a wake-up call. I decided that I should do more things with my head than with my hands. So, you know, I wanted to do something that is abstract, mathematical, but also has relevance to practice, and cryptography was a very natural choice. In the modern world, you care about privacy. You care about privacy more than you ever did. People now have tons of personal information, things like emails, medical records, financial records that they store remotely in a cloud. Of course, you care about the privacy of this information, so you want to encrypt it. But you also don't want your encryption to act as a black box. Before, we thought that privacy and functionality were antithetical to each other, but it turns out that is not quite the case. You can do many interesting things with data while it is encrypted, and that is what I do. I construct and design encryption systems where you can compute on data while it's encrypted. So in a sense, it's a bit like asking you to compute blindfolded, because here is the encryption, it's sitting on the table, you cannot see what's inside, and yet you can manipulate it. This type of encryption system is called the homomorphic encryption, and that's what I spent the last 5 years working on. Privacy is fundamental to our society, and the question is really, can it coexist with technological advancements? And I strongly believe that that is possible. Of course, you don't want to wait a couple of months to get your encrypted tax returns back. So we really want to make these technologies faster, more usable, and that is where I think the field is going.